welcome to another excellent Minute Microscopy. I'm the ever exuberant Eric Rosenblatt. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel and leave a comment. So today I'd like to talk about gambling. In particular, I'd like to ask the question, why is it illegal in so many parts of the US and the world for that matter? I use the term illegal loosely because in a way it kind of isn't, except when it is. Like, you can't just open your own casino like you could an antique store. You can't run your own sports betting operation without consequence, nor could you be a consumer of said things, unless they're state-sanctioned ones, of course. I mean, it's totally okay to purchase government scratch and lottery tickets, but make and sell them yourself, and it'll likely result in fines and jail time. Though somehow raffles are perfectly fine. Buy a ticket for a chance to win a prize, right? Isn't that just like the lottery? I'd like to hear a logical explanation for why one is against the rules and the other one is not. And I don't want to hear, because they said so. That's a nonsense argument. I just can't seem to wrap my head around why gambling isn't allowed when all other forms of gaming are, even ones that cost money to play and could come with cash winnings. But look here, they'll say. Those are games of skill, whereas casino-style games are not. That's the difference. To them, I respond, so? How does employing a learned skill in the game make it exempt from government oversight? There's still a significant amount of random chance in skilled games too, so where do we draw the line? Poker requires skill, but yet it often falls into that regulated category. Furthermore, where did this presumed authority to regulate the things we do for fun come from, and why do we allow it? I know I'm asking more questions than making statements here, but it's because I'm genuinely perplexed. Sure, casino-style gambling never favors the players. It's always more risky to them than it is to the house, and it can be addicting. But millions, perhaps billions of people enjoy gambling every day, and society hasn't collapsed yet. If the state argument is that they want to protect people from the risks associated with gambling, then why do they themselves provide their own gambling games to the public? Some of them come with way higher rewards than any casino would ever offer. That tantalizing prize is sure to entrap anyone with a gambling addiction. Of course, we all know the real reason government wanted to get involved in it. You viewers are more than clever enough to figure it out. Sad that the rest of the population seems to be unable to. I guess this is more of a shower thought croscopy. What are your thoughts? Share them in the comment section. I'll bet you $100 you won't, though.